I'm Ayanna Williams. I have one daughter. She's 12 years old, and I had a younger son. He would have been 11 months old. His name is Brandon Lawson.
My name is De'Ara, and I live in the northern part of Baltimore. I have a husband, 3 children, 4-year-old, his name is Eugene. I have a 1-year-old, her name is Sanaya, and I had a baby boy, his name was Charlie.
My name is Lottie Plumley. My son was born in Baltimore, Maryland on November 12, 2009. My son's name was William Woodward.
I basically got a phone call from another family member that was living in the house that the ambulance was at the home trying to resuscitate the baby and that they were rushing him to Hopkins. He was not in his crib, he was in the bed, in our bed.
When I woke up at 4:30, he was gone. We had found him dead in the middle of our bed.
On December 29th, Charlie passed away. He turned a month that day. That morning, he was in the bed with us. And when I woke up and looked over at him, he just wasn't breathing. If I had a chance to go back to December 29th, knowing what I know now, I probably would have changed a lot of things.
I have a 7-month-old baby, and I learned when I went to his doctor for his first appointment that all the babies need to sleep safe. That means alone, no parents, no brothers or sisters, on his back, not on his tummy, and in the crib. That means that in the crib, they don't need any bumpers or pillows or blankets, any teddy bears, no exceptions.
For you to be asleep with a baby, I don't think that's a good idea. I don't think it's worth the child's life. Research shows that babies who sleep with a parent are 3 times more likely to die than babies who sleep alone in a crib. Every month, an average of 2 babies less than a year old die in Baltimore City. These are preventable deaths.
I'm Dr. Avril Melissa Houston. I'm a pediatrician working for the Baltimore City Health Department, and I'm a mother of twins. It is so important that babies are put to sleep alone, on their back, and in a crib. When we go to sleep at night, we toss, we turn, and the little babies are not strong enough to kick back and say, "I'm still here, don't roll on me." And so that's how a lot of infants end up dying.
You could possibly roll over the baby, your arm, or the brother and sisters could, you know, put their arms on the windpipe and could suffocate, or the baby could possibly roll over to the side and not be able to get any air.
Since doctors have started telling moms to put their babies on their backs, 50% fewer babies have died due to SIDS.
When you sleep on your stomach, your windpipe is down, and that's where gravity flows. So if my baby were to spit up while they were sleeping on their stomach, it's a sure path down through the windpipe or the trachea into their lungs, and I knew I didn't want that to happen.
A safe crib should have absolutely nothing in it but the sheet, a mattress, and absolutely nothing else. No blankets, no bumpers, no bears, no toys, nothing but the baby, the sheet, and the mattress.
If you needed a crib, Baltimore City will give you a crib.
It's okay to share the room with your baby, but not your bed.
Well, it's very important to all the babies to sleep safe. And even if you say it won't happen to me or doesn't happen to all the babies, you never know. So sleep safe, alone, back, crib, and no exceptions.
I know a lot of times older people do things the way they did it when they were, you know, raising their children. And, you know, you just sometimes kind of have to let them know, this is how I want my baby to sleep, or, you know, this is where I want him to sleep. This is what I prefer for him or her. You know, it's your baby. You know, you have to let them know what you want for your baby. You know, at the end, it's you know, if something was to happen, you have to live with it, not them. You can never replace that child that you lost, ever. And you'll never, ever forget it. Something you have to live with every single day, to wake up and your arms be empty, or, you know, your home is missing a child, or, you know, you'll never be able to have grandchildren from that one child, or it's something you can just never, you can never change it.
I never expected this to happen. I don't think any mother really does. I haven't really hit the big milestones yet, like his birthday, which is coming up, the year anniversary.
I finally went to go visit Charlie's grave for the first time yesterday. You know, having to look in the ground for something that symbolizes where my son is, you know, where his body is. You know, that was hard in itself. And then finally finding it and seeing his name on this headstone, you know, my son, it was so hard.
I would tell other mothers just to really, really do what everybody says, you know, because I really, really, really don't want this to happen to anybody else.
It's something no one should ever have to experience, because it's the hardest thing to get through. I really miss Charlie, and I'll always love him with all of my heart. My love will never change for Charlie, because he's my baby. I really, really love my son.